Hi students, welcome back to our English class. We are discussing the lesson 1, Project Tiger from 2nd unit, The Frames. It is a memoir by Satyajit Ray. We can divide the article into two parts, Ray's Hollywood experience and Ray's own country experience. So, what difficulties and hard work were there behind these movies? Director has a vital role in making these films. And his whole crew used to stand with him to make the film successful. Sometimes they used real animals in films. At that time, they had to face so many difficulties such as to find the animals, controlling the animals. Sometimes they have to retake the same scene many times, etc. Let's move to the summary of the article. Ray's Hollywood experience. Ray said that no one can beat Hollywood when it comes to making films with animals in them. By this, Ray means that Hollywood animal movies are always on top. No other movies can reach up to the level of these movies. He remembered the films in his childhood days. One among them is Rin Tin Tin. The movie had an Alsatian. The dog's acting was more impressive than a human's. After that, he told about a collie called Lassie. It seemed that the director could make Lassie do just about anything. These trained dogs were famous stars in their own rights. The money they earned was like what a real film star got. The owners of these animals could easily make more than 1 lakh from just one film. Once Ray happened to see the shooting of a film 20 years ago in Disney studio in Hollywood. There he realized how respectfully these animals were treated. The main character in this film was a large dog. When he reached the studio, the shooting had not started and the cameraman was getting the lights ready. It is habitual for actors to be present when the lights are arranged. For the actors have to show the cameraman how they'll walk or where they will stand in a particular shot. In the case of very famous actors, this job was done by their stand-ins. You know stand-ins? See, a stand-in is usually a person who is physically similar to the real star. The stars themselves arrive only when the lights are ready. It is time to take a shot. Here, in Disney studio, he noticed that a few actors were moving about in the set. And on one side, there was standing the protagonist or this hero, the same large dog. The cameraman shouted to everyone to take their position, but the dog remained where it was. This confused him. He thought that it was not required in the next shot. Suddenly, a strange thing happened. From nowhere appeared a little dwarf, followed by another man carrying a hairy dog skin. Then, this dwarf, wearing this dog skin, went down on all the four on a chalk mark on the floor, just like an animal. Then he crawled from one mark to another, and the cameraman got busy with the lights. Finally, Ray understood that this dwarf was the dog's stand-in. Okay, let's move to the glossary. Reverently, respectfully, customary, habitual, draped, covered. Don't means understood. It's time for reading. No one can beat Hollywood when it comes to making films with animals in them. I remember films in my childhood and there were quite a few of them that had an Alsatian called Rin Tin Tin. This dog's acting was more impressive than a human's. Later, we got to see 3 or 4 other films with a collie called Lassie. It seemed that the director could make Lassie do just about anything. These trained dogs were very famous stars in their own rights. And the money they earned was no less than what a real film star got. Their owners could easily make as much as 100,000 rupees from just one film. I realized how reverently these animal actors were treated when I happened to see the shooting of a film 20 years ago in Disney studio in Hollywood. The main character in this film was a large dog. I reached the studio to find that the shooting had not yet started. The cameraman was getting the lights ready. It is customary for actors to be present when the lights are arranged, for they have to show the cameraman how they'll walk or where they will stand in a particular shot. In the case of very famous stars, this job is done by their stand-ins. A stand-in is usually a person who is physically similar to the real stars. The stars themselves arrive only when the lights are ready and it is time to take a shot. Here in Disney Studio, I noticed that a few actors were moving about in the set, and on one side, standing quietly, was the protagonist, the same large dog. The cameraman shouted to everyone to take their positions, but the dog remained where it was. This puzzled me. Could it be that it was not required in the next shot? Before I could ask someone, a strange thing happened. From nowhere appeared a little dwarf, followed by another man carrying a hairy dog skin. Then, to my perfect amazement, the dwarf went down on all the fours on a chalk mark on the floor, just like an animal, and the dog skin was draped over him. Then he crawled from one mark to another, and the cameraman got busy with the lights. It finally dawned upon me that this dwarf was paid to be the dog's stand-in. So, students, take your textbook and read it thoroughly. See you in the next class. Thank you.